So I've started the recording and welcome everyone to the teaching and learning call. We have a couple of project updates and announcements, it looks like. I'm looking at Etherpad right now. So I don't, Neil, are those yours that you wanted to talk about?
Yeah, a couple things. And then I just thought of another reminder. So we 10.10.6 RC01 is released just last night. So I'm going to be sending out, message today to ask for help testing, QA testing, because if we can get QA testing on this in the next week, maybe we can get it released next week, which would be nice. Kind of the way I'm also structuring that is I just have a sign-up sheet and asking what areas you're going to test. And I mentioned that SAMIGO testing quizzes and profile tools are two of the tools to focus on, and just a general check of the system. And I'm going to use, I think I'm, yeah?
SAMIGO profile, and was there one other primary one?
No, those are the two main ones, SAMIGO and profile tool, and then just a general check of the system. And that's... And I'm going to use, I think I'm going to try and use Slack, although I may not be that available to be on it today. So maybe more tomorrow and Friday. There's a cool tool. There's a couple of cool tools for doing chatting in real time once call that are getting very popular, not just within, you know, just all, overall in with the cool kids, I guess, which I'm not one, so I don't know. That's why I have to lag behind. But like HipChat and Slack, I think I'm going to try Slack out. I set up a Slack room for QA, and so that's on there. And if you're interested in QA, and if you're interested in you know, being part of the Slack, I think I have to invite you. I'm not sure, but I included a link to it in the. I included this information, of course, in the test plan. So that's happening over the next, starting over the next day or two, and hopefully we can just get a few days effort on it and get a 10.6 released, which would be really nice. Sakai, and there's like 90, right now there's 96 issues fixed. I think there's 8 blockers and 12 critical priority issues, so it's going to be a pretty significant fix. It's going to fix, I think, 20, a total of 20 critical and priority level issues in that release. And not around 96, maybe a little more than that, a few more than that issues total. Sakai 11, it looks like we're going to do a scope freeze for January 4th and probably a code freeze shortly after that, so that we can, and you know, we still have to figure a few things out, but then we're thinking we'll branch Sakai 11 at Sakai Camp in late January. We have 21 or 22. Eventbrite gives me two numbers. I haven't figured out how to reconcile them. One is the number of people registered, and the other is the number of people attending. And it says there's 21 registered and 22 attending. I'm not sure how that works. But so we've got 22 people or 21 or 22 people signed up. I think it's 22. I can count it manually. But anyway, I think it's 22 people signed up already, which is really awesome. That's going to be, I think, a fun event. And let me see, anything else in Sakai 11? And I guess I'll just mention briefly the Raleigh project, which is, so I have two more things I'll mention real quickly. The Raleigh project, it looks like they're getting ready to, they're in the process of picking a vendor to do the work. That's the accessibility effort. And so I expect an announcement on that within weeks. Very soon. So that's pretty exciting. So we can probably get that started, that effort started. And I want to also put in a plug, which I know people are really busy. It's the end of semester and it's hard to get focused or get extra time to work on QA. So in addition to 10.6, another ongoing effort for testing is the Morpheus tool by tool testing. So we still could use you know, more community participation. Like I said, I understand with 10.6 going out and with the end of semester activities and the holidays coming up, it's hard to get some attention, but I just want to mention that again. And I think, let's see, I think that covers most of it except for the little educause thing I put on there. Can someone paste in the Morpheus tool by tool testing, or maybe I can find it real quickly?
It's there.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, it's there.
Cool, Awesome, there it is. Yeah, so I encourage you to think about that. The nice thing about the tool-by-tool testing, so the nice thing about the 10.6 testing is with a little bit of effort, we can get 10.6 out the door, which I think the community really needs. And the nice thing about the tool-by-tool testing for Morpheus is you don't need any technical expertise. It's really about, you know, what the tool, where, because of all these new interface changes we've done with Morpheus for responsive design, it's really more about how things look. So all you have to do is basically look at the screen, and if it looks kind of funky and it looks off and kind of weird, then you take a screenshot. And then you can open a JIRA, or if you're not comfortable opening a JIRA, you can send me or Mariano or, you know, one of the team an email with the screenshots, and we'll get a JIRA open. So so it should be, you know, kind of fun and easy to do. So think about that. And I'm just going through my brain here. And then the EDUCAUSE presentation thing kind of at a totally different track. So there is a marketing effort. So far, it's me and Saul Wakan and Matt Burgess are the community representatives from that, and we'll be happy if other people want to consider joining on as we get a little further in the process. And we had our first meeting, with some Sakai commercial affiliates, so that was really cool. And we're going to meet again, I think, this Friday. And not a lot to report except we're sort of brainstorming different ways to get the word out about Sakai. We're thinking that we would like the community to participate in, you know, really focusing on Sakai 11, and you know, using that as not the release of Sakai 11 as an opportunity for marketing. And the reason I put EDUCAUSE down there is because EDUCAUSE is super, super expensive. As if you're like a vendor, it's you know, our vendors are relatively, you know, small. They're not like giant multinational corporations or giant companies, and so, you know, getting things at EDUCAUSE or having booths at EDUCAUSE is very expensive. So a more economical thing that we can do as a community is if there's presentations by, you know, faculty, instructional designers, technical people, perhaps you could consider, you know, submitting a proposal for EDUCAUSE that might have a Sakai 11 connection. And the due date on EDUCAUSE, I believe, is January 20th. So it's coming up really fast. And also, they are very, very selective. It's a huge conference. They have tons of proposals. So, you know, you may not get accepted unless it's a really unique type of innovative proposal, but it could be worth a shot. And so we're hoping that people in the community might consider, you know, whether they might have something particularly interesting to share and make a Sakai connection with it. An example of one that did happen last EDUCAUSE was on analytics, learning analytics, which is going really full guns, and they had some Sakai connections, you know, Josh Barron and company. So I just wanted to make a little bit of a pitch for that.
Great idea. Do you happen to know if EDUCAUSE still does poster sessions? I wonder if that might be another way of presenting information around Sakai 11 specifically. They used to a long time ago.
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, that could be a way where maybe poster sessions wouldn't be so expensive to get something there, but have a presence and have some visibility. So that's
right.
An excellent suggestion.
And I'm not saying form of Sakai vendor type of thing, but rather similarly, people who are using it who might want to do a poster session as opposed or in addition to presentation proposal.
Sure. Well, I think that's a great suggestion, and also it's something where you know, maybe that would justify me going to EDUCAUSE on behalf of the community if it was for, you know, poster session, although it's not my favorite conference to go to just because there's a lot of great content, but to me it's a bit overwhelming. Yeah. I find it a bit overwhelming. I think it's like 5,000 or so people, and yeah. Great. But, you know, that's a thing to consider.
Yeah.
So I think that's a really cool suggestion, because it could be somebody in the community, if they're already doing a presentation or if they're already at EDUCAUSE, maybe they could represent the community into Sakai 11, or maybe they could do something relative to their institution in Sakai 11. So yeah, I think that is a really, I really like that suggestion a lot.
Yeah. I think you should be there, Neil. Whoever does any of this, having you there as well with, you know, to help with conversations would be just, that's my gut feeling about that.
Yeah, I've done that. I've done that a couple of times before. Maybe the way it was structured was not, it didn't feel effective to me, but it may have been the way we were doing it, which is that I was kind of going between the different commercial affiliate booths and making a presence there. And I think I did maybe one presentation or two presentations on the floor, but I stayed all in that kind of vendor techie area. And it didn't feel like there was a lot of attention. So maybe if we had a different strategy, we could, it could make it worthwhile.
Yeah. Well, that's an interesting idea. And I think that is a probably a good venue, although, as you say, it's also overwhelming, not just for us, but I'm sure a lot of people. So, but yeah, I think we should, that's a, you know, we should be there.
And so anyway, so that's for, I think that covers most of the things going on that I can think of off the top of my head. So there.
Right. Okay. Thank you. That's really great. And I know the QA stuff is really important and time sensitive. So as many people as can spare some time to participate in that, the better. So I failed to settle upon a Jira of the Week. So I don't know if anybody has one off the top of their heads that they want to talk about. If so, we can do that. But if not, we'll just move on to our main speaker.
I do have one, but it's not urgent, but it's but if I can put it out there and see if people want to talk about it. It's let me get the link right here. And I forget if we've talked about this one before. It feels like we maybe did. It's SAK26356. And it's has to, and this may be one that requires some thought outside of the meeting, but it's a handling of assignment feedback on student resubmissions. So this is for the assignments tool. And the question is, you know, what to do with instructor. You know, the idea is that if you're an instructor and you're doing a resubmit and you're allowing a resubmission from a student, wouldn't you want the feedback to go when you say, okay, you can do a resubmission, so that way the student will get the feedback and he or she can know, oh, that's the feedback I need to work on. So when I resubmit my assignment, it's going to be, you know, I'm going to understand what the instructor is wanting to see, so I can adjust and hopefully do a better job on my resubmission. But the way it works currently is that because grades and comments are released at the same time, even though you have a resubmission, it does not release the instructor comment because that's tied with the that's tied up with the grade, right? So that's where you have the discussion about how should this behave.
Yeah, and I think there has been conversation around this in a different JIRA, actually, because I'm sure that I commented in one of the JIRAs about this, but I don't see any comments from me in this one. So,
I wonder if it's SAK26323. Let me see if that's...
let me see.
Because I'll paste that in, because that one's already fixed, actually.
But I'm sure it was around this notion of handling save and don't release versus allowing resubmission.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds familiar to me too.
I will try to find my comments about that from before and review them, and if they seem relevant to the current JIRA 26356, I'll paste them in.
Okay. Thanks. And if it is a different JIRA, maybe it's already been resolved and we just need to close that one out. I guess that's a possibility as well.
Right.
Okay. Well, that's good for me.
Thank you. So we're going to turn it over now to Mariano, who's going to be talking to us about using OAE for teaching and learning. So, Mariano, please take it away.
Hello, thank you. Can you see my screen right now?
Yes, we can see yours. Yep.
Cool. I'll go to the present mode. Okay, so so hello everyone. My name is Jose Mariano Luján from the University of Murcia, and I will be talking today about how we're using OAE for an online master program. And I will give you more details in the presentation. Please stop me at any moment if you have a question or afterwards, there's no problem. Actually, the most important thing for me is to get feedback from all of you also. So I've done this presentation a couple of times before, so I just somehow reused most of the slides. So the University of Murcia, which is located in the south of Spain, offers a OAE tenant since February 2014. So it's open to everyone at our university. So anyone with a email account from our university can log into OAE. Is connected to through the single sign-on, which in our case is CAS. When they log in for the first time, their account is created and they're gonna start using OAE. And if they are logging already in another application, or like Sakai or Webmail, or you know, any of the ones that are connected with the SSO, they don't need to enter any email or anything. So that's very, very convenient for everyone. We have to admit that our main collaborative tool at our university is Sakai project sites. So OAE is being used, but not as much as we could expect. Just because it has not been announced too broadly for some other reasons, but the people that use it, they use it a lot. So I will be talking about a specific use case, which is for an online master program, which I work part-time for them. And this master program actually won an honorable mention in 2012 from the Teaching with Sakai Innovation Award. And at that time, we were not using OAE. So it was just what we presented was just a combination of Sakai tools and how we were using every Sakai tool to actually to make the master program work, right? So this is the website screenshot of the website of the master. How do we use it for? Well, a little bit of background about this master. So our main platform for delivering the content is Sakai. So we only use OAE for some specific use cases within this master program. We have 50 students every year, more or less. We divide them into 10 groups in Sakai, because they do like group assignments and so on. Those groups, we put them also in OAE, and I will tell you how later on. We've been using OAE since September 2014, which is last academic year. So this year is our second year using OAE, compulsory for the students. And we use it in 13 courses. I will tell you how in a minute. In terms of training, it's pretty simple. So because OAE is really intuitive, so I usually do a 1 hour, 2 hour session with instructors and TAs for like refreshing the concepts and do some testing before they actually go into the course. And do work with the students. And in terms of the students, I do like I handle them some information in PDF, which I think I have a screenshot further on in the presentation. I if necessary, I do like like one assignment with them, a collaborative assignment, so that they can practice before they actually go into their first course. And this session is about 1 hour. So not much will we have to put, like the effort that we have to do in terms of training. I said that we basically use Akai, but we also use Adobe Connect for video conference because it's a fully online master program. So that's the reason why we're playing with all these technologies. Right now we have these three components within the master programs, which is Sakai, Adobe, and OA. So the university offer these three platforms to students, because we are aware that they also use, you know, other tools like Facebook or WhatsApp or things like that in order to communicate with their colleagues and, you know, or Google Docs. But OA, Sakai, and Adobe Connect, you know, is the tool that actually we, or university says, hey, we offer these tools for you to work. If they want to use other tools, it's fine also, but we thought this was a really important concept. So that the university actually offers them a place for doing collaborative work. So that's where OA fits into this concept, right, of having the university offering them the different platforms. So before going any further, is there any question up until here?
Yeah, this is Neil. I'm just curious, when you're doing, it seemed like you're able to do training in a very short period of time. That sounds really encouraging. So it sounds like people pick it up pretty quickly.
Yeah, they do. And you will see, I mean, the OAE has a really minimum set of functionality. So that's why it's not complex. Like every, I don't know if they have like five or six different things that you can do, like groups or discussions or, and we don't use all of them. So so we just tell them, you know, what we are going to be using. To be honest, the people usually pick it up like really, really quick. Like for example, for Sakai, I spent like one week and a half, like working on things, right? Like on assignments, on like before they actually go into the course. So we do like an online introduction course, which is 1 week and a half. And they have assignments that they have to do, and those assignments reproduce real use cases that they will have to do in the real courses. So I have, you know, many, many more problems in terms of them understanding, you know, how to hand in an assignment or things like that. And the OAE, in terms of how it works, it's really simple. But I also have other problems, which I will also mention. So it's not that it's, you know, marbles, but in terms of training, I think it's pretty simple. Okay, so if there is any more questions, if not, I will continue. So I will be talking about three main use cases, like three use cases that we use, that we've been actually using, and we do use it like almost every day. So the first one is within this master program. So the first one is about the collaborative editing. So we call it wiki style, or we call it like this here, because we came from using the wiki for one of the assignments. In every of the 13 courses, one of the assignments was to participate in a wiki. But we had a lot of problems with the wiki, that it's the one that, you know, that comes within Sakai. The main problem was that for this particular assignment that we do with the students, they have to participate in the wiki, the 50 students, in like 3 days. So they have to do like one specific assignment within 3 days. And the wiki that comes with Sakai has a lot of problems with concurrency. So I got a huge amount of complaints, like people losing their work and things like that. So we tried to find other tools, and we thought that OAE could fit, you know, into the assignment that we were actually giving to them, that it was supposed to be a wiki, but now we call it OAE wiki. But you will see how it works in a minute. So for this first use case, it's compulsory for students, compulsory for instructors. The master controls the groups, so we actually invite the students or put the students into those groups, and they have 3 days to actually do their work, so they have to do it within those 3 days. And it's just one activity, one activity for each one of the 13 courses, right? So it's not that much. So that's the first use case. The second use case is that we suggest students that they use OAE for their collaboration. So when they have to do group assignments, they have to hand in Sakai group assignments, we tell them, okay, you could use Google Docs or whatever, but you know, we are not forcing you to create a Google account and to do the work in Google. We offer, or the university offers you, a solution which is OAE, which you can access with the same email account that you are accessing in Sakai, and you can, you know, log into this system, create a group with your students, like partners, peers, and then work on that assignment. And then once it's done, then you hand in the assignment in Sakai in the assignments tool. Right, so they are responsible for creating the group, and they are responsible for doing that or for not doing that. Right, so we don't enter there. And then we also use it for collaboration between instructors from the master program, because that's also a good way of training them. So we actually I will put some materials in OAE for them to review, or in order to create the groups, I will start creating the groups in OAE and tell them, well, if you get an email from one of the students, please make a note in OAE. And, you know, it's our way for doing that collaborative way. So I will go now into the three use cases. So the first one, as you might remember, it was a compulsory, the wiki style. So this is how I introduced the students actually to OAE, is with a real example. So I tell them, because it's an online program, I tell them to log into OAE for the first time, access a document that I have already set up in OAE, and I tell them to write their name and to tell me from which city they come from. And if somebody has already, you know, talk about the same city, they can maybe add something to that, so that they understand the concept of the collaborative editing, and that they can actually, you know, improve the work that his colleague has done, or maybe check some of the information. Maybe there is some typos, some mistakes, and things like that. Because I must admit that when they complain about the wiki, most of the time they don't complain about the tool, but they complain about other students actually messing up with their with their submission, right? So that's something that I'm sure that we will have a huge discussion here. So they're not complaining about the tool itself, but they're complaining about the activity, like how the activity is presented to them. So so this is the interface of OAE for the collaborative documents. For those of you that are not familiar, this is a Etherpad document embedded in OAE. So it has pretty much the same functionality that the Etherpad that we're using here for the notes. And each student gets a color assigned to him, and you know, they can do some basic styling on the text, but really, really basic. So as I mentioned before, we create the groups for them. So we know we have already the groups created from in Sakai. We use the tool Section Info, for those of you that might know that tool. Section Info allows you in Sakai to create multiple groups And it uses the concept of categories. So you can create maybe 10 groups within the same category. So what that means is that a student cannot belong to two groups within the same category. So they're really easy for us when we are creating the groups, because we use the same category for all the groups, and then we know if we are missing some students or not. Or so we have 50 students and we create groups of 10 people. So in a way, so here you can see a screenshot. So this is one of the groups. It's called Wiki 5, so it's W5. You can see it on the title, and then activity 4, and then the name of the course. I mentioned that we have 13 courses, so Estudio de Visitantes, that's the name of one of the courses. So here you can see that we have the students, and we have the instructor, the TA, and then the other account, which is the last one over there, is for the master program. So it's for administration, for creating the groups and so on. So and this is how it looks when you create so many wikis. So we create for each of these, I mentioned that for each course, we create like 5 groups of 10 people. So each one of those groups is called, it's a wiki. So we call it wiki 1, wiki 2, wiki 3, wiki 4, and wiki 5. And they work, the 10 students work within their wiki, like within their collaborative document. They do the work over there during the 3 days that they have to work on that. And then afterwards, the instructor can take all of that content from, like, the instructor sees 5 groups, and in each group there is a shared document. So the instructor can take export like the 5 documents and share it with everyone in Sakai, in the forum. So he can actually say, oh, so here is the result of each wiki, and you know, and people can comment, and the debate can continue. But people are not working anymore in the collaborative document. So the assignment has been closed after the 3 days. But we try to tell instructors to do that, to actually take the information out and make it available for the other groups to know what the other group have done, in order for them to actually have more information. So this is how it looks for the administration part of the master program, let's say. So this is how I see it. So I see that I have created the 5 groups, the 5 wikis for one course, the other 5 wikis, or in this case, I had 7 wikis because, it was, we had more students in that edition, but this is basically how we handle. So each of these squares is a group within OE. And this is the view inside the group. So when we click into one of these groups, let's say, for example, we go into Wiki 3. So now we are inside Wiki 3. And here we have really basic tools. We have the recent activity, which is like when you log into Facebook and you have the activity feed. So it tells you everything that have happened around, within your group. Then you have the library, which is Biblioteca, and then there is where they can find the shared document, which is the first one over there. But they can actually upload, more documents or pictures or even folders for everyone to work in the collaborative assignment. So they have everything, under this umbrella of the group. They can actually share different things and work together. And this is how it looks when you actually enter the shared document, right? So we are here in the group. So now we enter the shared document, and this is how it looks. So one of the most, I would say, all the functionality that I personally like the most, and that I think that the students like the most about OAE, which is different from just using Etherpad, is that the OAE team has provided a comment area at the bottom of the document, where they can actually, you know, make comments or like have a discussion around the document. So they do the collaborative editing. Most of the time, the instructors or the TA give them some indice, like a structure of the points that they have to cover. And depending on the assignment, depending on the course, they provide more information to them, or it's up to the student to actually, you know, create the content and create the section. So that depends on the course. But the comment area is really important, because they can actually, and I've seen a lot of real use cases where one student will, you know, log in the first one to the OE and will say, okay, so we have this structure. Okay, so I will be doing part 2.1. Somebody will be doing part 2.3. We need a couple of people to work in the other two parts. And, you know, they can reply to that person. The TA or the instructor can actually participate in this discussion. So that's an interesting piece of functionality that is built within the OE. And then the functionality that was introduced, I think, a couple of versions ago, that is to have folders. So you can actually organize content into folders. They use it sometimes for creating like certain pictures, because it's, the master is about museums and education and heritage. And so, you know, they have a lot to share in terms of images and things like that. So that's the first part, and I think I don't know if there is any question that has been.
There are some questions.
Okay. I think we can take them now.
Regarding that first section, so Terry asked if there is a connection to OAE, like an LTI or some other way to get it into Sakai. I'm guessing.
No, it's not. Like the way we are doing it right now, and because we have the single sign-on, is that we add a link within the Sakai site, a link using the website, I don't know how it's called in English, the web content? Yeah, web content. So we add a link that just point to OAE. And because it's transparent to them, because they don't have to log in into OAE, but there is no connection. That's sometimes a problem.
Yeah, gotcha. And do you have to use section info to create the groups, or can you create the groups using the manage groups feature in site info?
I think you could use both. We just use section info because it's for me it's simpler. Because the concept that I mentioned about the categories, because I just choose one category and I just keep like throwing people to groups, because I have to create like I think 10 groups. It's just simple for me, because every time I'm gonna create a new group, I can't find the students that I have already been assigned in the student list. Because because the concept of section is that within the same category, a student cannot belong to two sections. So that's why I use it, right?
Okay. So it's good to know that either can probably be used. And so we're all excited about your use of Etherpad in OAE and how much better that is than the current wiki in Sakai. And I think we'll be curious to know about how that integration, you know, how that works. And you don't have to take time to do it, to talk about that right now, but that might be something we would want to talk about later. Are you still there? Oh, lost your audio. Okay. It looks like, why don't you go to the headset icon and just redo the audio. Yeah. I think sometimes that has happened to me.
Okay, so can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Yeah, it say that I lost the RTI point or something. Okay, yeah.
That's okay. Well, you can just continue now, I think.
Okay, great. So, so the second use case. So, as I mentioned, this is not compulsory. This is optional. We just somehow we provide them a way of, you know, doing collaborative work. So I just provide them a PDF, a simple PDF with some screenshots, like you can see here, like how to create a group, the different options for visibility that you have, and then here on the right you can see one of their groups. I got access to one of their groups to actually see a real example. So here you can see this is group F they created. I don't have access. I asked them to put it public for me to check it and do the screenshot. And here you can see that they created a collaborative document for working on the final activity, and they make comments, you know, within the document, outside the document. So we are aware that they use it actually they find it useful for doing collaborative work on their own. And this is how a student will see it. So this is a student, and they have all the groups that we create for them. And then they have a group C in this case, which is a group that they created for themselves, which none of the instructors or me have access to that group. Collaboration between faculty. Well, this is just like I mentioned before, this is like the same use cases. Like actually OAE does not have a lot of functionality, so you cannot do many things. So it's just for, you know, doing like a quick collaboration, or if you want to create a 40 or 50 page document, maybe you better use a Google Doc right now than use OAE. But for taking some minutes or to create to create the groups, for example, here to organize during the first weeks, a student change group all the time because they cannot work with these people, or they, you know, they have a conflict on their schedule or things like that. So it's really convenient for having, you know, a group of a space where you can actually collaborate with people, and then a space for comments. And this is the instructors from this online master program. We work also in a MOOC project last year, in order to work on that MOOC. We use OAE, so we created our group in OAE, and we share all the content over there, presentations and things like that. We basically, I basically like to do that, so that the instructors get used to the use, and, you know, and they it does not they don't have to wait one more year to work again on their course with OAE for only 3-4 days. So we try to keep it, you know, ongoing for during the whole year. So this is how we link to OAE. As I mentioned, it's just a link. I wish it could be more. For example, that we could transfer the groups from here to OAE and things like that. But so far, there are two platforms that are not really talking to each other. So we just combine them in the way that we can. And some feedback that we collected from students. So we asked them to rate, their satisfaction with the use of OAE, and, you know, out of 27, you can see here that most of the responses were good. Also about what did they think that about OAE for this online master program, and they say that it was accessible, attractive, participative, dynamic, intuitive, complete. And then the other question was, if they has used OAE if OAE has been useful for their wiki work, and, you know, out of 27, 23 say that it was good. And then we also asked a couple of more questions, if they have used it for working, you know, with their group, like on their, in the second use case that I described. And out of 41, 34 say that they had used it for that. And then the other question is that, you know, if they have used it for working in group. Oh, okay, so it's the same question. Okay, from 2 different years, from 2 different courses. Yeah, and out of 27, 22, yeah. So it's the same question from 2 different courses. Yep. Some more questions. This is just like after we finish every course, we do like a, I don't know how you say it, like a feedback survey. Yeah, a survey. And here they also mention all things like this, like they think that OE allows them to create collaborative content, to interact with peers, to distribute complementary tasks, to develop personal relations through collaboration, to work in groups. And so basically, most of the responses were good. I have not prepared a demo, but I could, for sure, if you want, maybe I could log in into the system and you know, jump into one of the groups, or we could take questions and so it's up to all of you.
So thank you so much, Mariano. Yeah, we have a couple more questions. Well, I was curious to know, was your MOOC open to the world, or
yes, it is.
It is, gotcha.
It's I'll paste the link. It's in a platform that is
okay.
from Spain. It's in Spanish, the MOOC, and it's I think it's 4 weeks long. Right now is closed, but I'm sure there will be another opportunity to do the course. I think maybe February or March. I think yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it was finished. I think like 3 weeks ago. Something like that.
I had a question, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Sure.
I just wondered, did you ever consider using OAE as a replacement for the forums as a sort of experiment, see if it worked better?
No, because we have not had complaints with forums in Sakai.
Really?
Well, we do have, yeah, we have some complaints, but not as big as the one that we got with a wiki. So we didn't want to distract, you know, people around. And actually, like, as I said, like OE does not have as much functionality as OE has. I mean, as Sakai has. So for example, from the forums, you can't grade a forum, or you can't I don't know right now which ones we actually use, or for example for evaluation, Sakai lets you, you know, within a course, within a forum, you can see how many participation a student have had, or you can actually go to those participation really easy, because you have a page with all the links to all the participations. So you don't have that in OAE, and we actually had some problems in OAE in order to track the student work within the collaborative document, because it tells you like every modification, but when you access the modifications, I think I could see if I can real quick. So this is our OE. So here is the groups. So you can see we have many, many, many groups right now. So I'm going to go, for example, to this one. And this is the introduction course. So you can see here I have the 50 students, all of them with their, or most of them with their picture. And if I go to the library, I have the shared document here, where I ask them to tell me about their city, right?
Yeah.
And then here, they have comments about that. And then, so here's the problem. When you go to the revisions and you check between 2 different revisions, there is no, they don't highlight what has changed. So that's tricky.
Yeah.
In order to, but the OAE did a presentation last Wednesday after the teaching and learning call, which I attended for a little bit, and they say that the next functionality that they will be providing is to actually highlight the different changes. And a really promising thing that that they mentioned is that they are working on an integration with LibreOffice, which will allow people to actually create documents like documents and also spreadsheets and maybe slides. So that will really make a difference. So that's really hot news from last week. They don't have a date for that because they depend on a third party. And probably I'm not the best one to talk about that. That should be Nicholas, but because he knows all the information. But he mentioned that it was on the roadmap, and that will definitely be that would be awesome if they actually do that.
Yeah, I just wanted to make a comment. I spoke to Nico at Baltimore, and I said, have you got any plans to add LTI support to OAE? And he kind of said, well, we'd like to, but, no one's really asking for it. We're not really sure whether, anyone would use it. So I posted a comment saying, if quite a lot of us say we think it'd be fantastic, we'd use OAE if you did it, then you never know, something might happen.
So, Adam, are you saying that there's two ways that LTI support could be added, right? One is as so that OAE could be used as an LTI tool, and the other way is OAE.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, yeah. Yeah, okay. just add it. So, you link it in as a tool in Sakai, and of course Sakai can pass over information about the site, and then you'd get over the problem that not really being able to relate an area in OAE with a Sakai site. So you could have a kind of one-to-one relationship. And so you treat it as an extra tool, a collaborative authoring stroke wiki, whatever tool. That'd be great, wouldn't it?
I mean, just so you know, there have been, for several years, we've been talking about that the wiki tool in Sakai is really dated, and it's meeting, people are still using it, but it's meaning it's harder, it's outdated and meeting less needs. And we have been talking about a path of, and I know this is tangential, so I won't spend a lot of time, but we were talking about, XWiki as a possible replacement and getting an LTI integration for that. And so that would be, I think, an interesting discussion, is talk about community needs around a wiki tool and what path.
Well, also, given the fact that we wouldn't actually have to host, or no institution would actually have to host OAE because it is hosted centrally and everyone has access to it. So the only bit of work really is doing the LTI stuff. You don't have to pay any hosting charges or anything like that. It's just once you've linked to it, it's there forever and you can use all the functionality. So it would be brilliant. Because I think a lot, what would put a lot of people off XWiki is that it's yet another tool to have to host. So, you've got Sakai, and it's nice because Sakai's got all the tools built in, but now you've got to host a wiki. So you think, forget the wiki, I'm not hosting another tool. I'll just stick with Sakai without the wiki. So I think there's been lots of advantages.
Yeah, I was trying to look for the Sakai Camp website because...
Sure, let me paste that in for you.
Okay, cool. Because there was a... I don't know who added that to the Sakai camp.
Me, but,
okay, but it's I saw a couple of interesting points at the in the agenda.
Good.
And it's
And the agenda is not fixed either. I mean, we can also modify it, as a community.
Right. So, folks, we have about 5 minutes left in our hour, and I wanted to post the link to the Etherpad, and I'm sorry to abruptly end this discussion, which is really interesting, and first I'd like to thank you, Mariana, for your presentation. It was really interesting and has started a lot of us thinking about some interesting thoughts around Etherpad, XWiki, and integrations into Sakai. So that's very exciting.
Yeah, thank you everyone for, yeah.
Absolutely, and I know we look forward to talking with you more about at various venues about the OAE work that you guys are doing. But we do need, I would like to ask everyone to jump over to Etherpad for a moment. So we just spend a moment, see if we can fill the January 20th time slot. And I've posted the upcoming schedule and below that some of the unscheduled topics. And wanted to see if anybody would like to volunteer for the January 20th time slot. I know that I'm not sure if Neil, if the virtual conference, I know there's some the funds from the virtual conference. I know there's a group that's already looking at ideas. If that might be a time when that group could report back,
I think it's
teaching and learning.
The group, because we just started, we just nominated a chair, and we just brainstormed ideas, and I think we want to get some feedback at the Sakai camp. So I don't think we're really going to have. I'm guessing.
Okay.
After this attack camp.
That's fine.
And
well,
then we'll probably
tell you what.
Community input and things like that.
Yeah, sure. That makes sense. I think we'll just table this for today, and I know we'll have a couple of sessions in which we can spend some time trying to come up with a topic for that session. So we're not. We're not in any urgent need to fill it right now. But if anybody has any suggestions in the meantime and is willing to volunteer, you can send an email to me or Neil or Matt Burgess to tell us what you'd like to talk about, and we'll plug you into that time slot. In the meantime, I will wish everybody a happy holiday and look forward to coming back in January, and Neil is going to be talking to us about questions and suggestions for the Sakai camp. So hopefully we'll all have some good ideas and to share and make that a really good topic for conversation. Does anybody have anything else they'd like to add before we adjourn? All right.
Happy holidays. Happy holidays.
Thank you. Happy holidays.
Yeah, happy holidays, everyone.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mariano. Thanks again for the presentation.
Oh, no problem. A pleasure.
Yes, thank you. All right. Signing off. Thanks, everyone.
Bye. Bye.